Hey man, you ever looking to flatter?
I'm going to stand back and just show you where my camera's at. This is where I normally film from. There's this little path and there's the boardwalk that they put out here. And I usually can't get that that close to the water out here. You know, sometimes I'm right in this general area. Here's one of the corrections. It was a misidentification for Hernando Beach rack. Was really showed as Billy Steele's rack, and Cutter's rack was showed as the Billy Steele's was actually Cutter's rock. But all the distances are correct. So this really is some good footage. It's some good proof of what was actually shown. The only problem is that it was a misidentification of one rack. So later, at the end of this video, which was well put together by Taboo Conspiracy, he did a wonderful job, and I just want to put this video back out with these corrections in, and then at the end of the video, I will add in the extra footage that was actually not shown that does show Cutter's rock, but we overlooked it, and I overlooked it, and my journey out to all of these racks, I overlooked it, misidentified it myself, so it threw everything off. We both took down this video, but I'm going to put it back up with these corrections because, again, it was well put together, well explained, and it was an awesome video that I want to give a big amount of credit to Taboo Conspiracy for doing all this research. And if it wasn't for my mistake, we would have had everything put together really, really nicely. All right, here we go. And again, you know, I'm saying that the water's actually even up higher, you know, and you see the mirroring going on underneath that rack. Of course, it's distorted. It looks like a mirage, but
There's no magical force pulling that up. You can see birds land on the damn thing, for crying out loud. As I zoom back, you know, you can see the layers of clouds. And there's always that little gray spot in there that I like to call the gray area, because that's where I think that convergence is at. And again, look at the mirroring that occurs on this. Okay, see the mirroring of those bird racks? And what's cool is seeing the birds. The birds give it away. It shows you that they can be in mid-flight and they'll disappear underneath that mirroring area. And that's why I say that's what cuts off buildings and objects, is that mirroring effect that occurs. It's an illusion. And there's was that Bill Watts rack right there? Zoom in on it and see how it's being affected there. Hopefully we can catch one of these birds or something. Okay, here we go. Okay, I'm back down here at Bayport again. There's the deck. There's my camera. And look how much farther in the water is. Okay, I'm just gonna let it sit there, shall I? What I'm curious of is if I can find that other bird rack that I tried to find this morning. What I'm curious of is if I can find that other bird rack that I tried to find this morning. That bird rack is 9 miles out, 8.5, something like that. There it is. Should be a sign coming up here. No, shit, there's the bird rack. That other rack must have been something else. Holy crap, look at that. And then there's one to the right of this one too. Look at that. That's even further back. Holy crap. There's the sign. Huh? So tell me, how am I seeing that? I couldn't see it this morning because of the light refraction, but here I can see it now. It even looks like a boat or a canoe or something sitting out there. He's just doing some flats fishing or something.
Tomato, tomato, potato, patata, refraction, reflection.
Look at the difference in the size of the boats. Too, look how little that boat is. And that one's actually a big boat. There's perspective for you again.
this rack was where I actually made my big mistake. It was Hernando Beach rack. And then it threw me off on the Billy Steele's rack and Cutter's Rock. But I am going to make that correction at the end of this video. This is the original video that both I and Taboo Conspiracy took down because of this big mistake. But he had put so much into this, I wanted to reuse it, but add in the corrections and also show that in this footage, I did have Cutter's Rock in there. And I even overlooked it in the video. Again, keep watching. This is excellent, excellent research that Ben did and excellent observations that I made.
All that reflection. If I can find this other. The shrimp boat coming in. Billy Steel Rack. That's Cutter's Rock.
We're going to get on the other side to see what the sign says. See which bird rack this is. But we are way offshore. It just says Cutter's Rock. Okay, so this is Cutter's Rock.
Whoa.
Again, I want to make this perfectly clear. That was not Cutter's Rock. That was actually Billy Steele's at 7.78 miles away. Like I said, I will actually show the original footage, which this is part of Cutter's Rock. Again, it was overlooked. I misidentified a few of these, and it threw everything off. But there was so much research that Ben put into this. Again, I want to give him the biggest majority of the credit for doing a lot of the work. Of course, I will take the credit for the observational work, but I just want to make the point clear that this is not Cutter's Rock. It's not 11.5 miles away. And we're going to make this correct and proper and actually show the original footage toward the end. And you make your mind up. You decide. But you can also see how this bird rack is getting compressed. Again, I want to point out the next rack coming up is the actual Hernando Beach rack. I can tell by the little extra thing sticking out the side, the post. But I just want to make that perfectly clear again. This is a misidentified rack.
There's the North Rack. Look at that. Even got that little light flashing on it, on the North Rack. And look at the water well behind it. Oh, yeah, baby. Perfect day, perfect visibility. Look at that. Woohoo. And I'm going to do this last shot here. This beautiful sky. Look at that. Look at that. nine something miles out there, and you can see water well beyond it.
Alright, this is the original footage that I had taken that, actually it was 2017, December 17th, and this was the actual last video that I took on this night, but I had gotten some footage before this that was absolutely crazy. You see this boat right here, and in the beginning there you could see what looked like some islands, but I think what they were was a group of boats that were out there that were close together, that just due to the angular resolution, they were just blending all in together. You couldn't see the gaps, but this is obviously a boat that's well out there on the horizon, hauling ass, creating a wake. And you know what you're seeing at the tail end is probably the wake of the boat. It could be the boat also just being compressed quite a bit due to, again, the angular resolution. I'm going to put a link to a video from Mitchell from Australia in either the description or in a comment with a link to his video, because I think he explained it very, very well. But, you know, there was a few other things that I mentioned and added into the previous video. Of what I think is also part of what's going on. Like right here, I can see the mirroring occurring at the convergence point that a lot of people don't actually see. The light diffraction really is what's blocking us off from seeing it, the true horizon. And there's many reasons for this, which I will try to do videos more in the future explaining how the entire horizon drops due to bad visibility, where you get this false hard water line, visible water line that is not the true water line, and that is not where the curve begins. there is no curve, it's all flat, but due to our angular resolution, the distances that we are seeing, everything gets pinched off, it converges, and then you also have the mirroring effect that occurs either close or very, very far away. I was tracking this boat that was far out there. Sorry about the shakiness, but you know, I also zoom in, zoom out, and show you how far out. I mean, at this point, you see absolutely nothing. This point you see nothing, and then you start seeing something right about here of that boat way out there. So it's actually beyond our visible eye range, our actual visibility with our natural eye. You cannot see it, but there it is again, and it's way out on that horizon, and you can see that the horizon is still going on beyond that boat. And again, this is why things vanish bottom up. The boat that just went across the screen is still at a long distance away, but you can actually see the boat in the water without the lower portion getting cut off by these false illusions that we get that is created by our atmospheric conditions or climate conditions is really a better word to use. But because everybody's familiar with the word atmosphere, that maybe just getting into the flat earth will understand that better than, you know, us saying atmosplane, because they would have no idea what you're talking about when you say atmosplane. So again, you know, I'm all about doing observational work. I'm not great at editing. I'm not great at computer work. There's a lot of programs that I don't have in my computer to do, like, screenshots of, you know, while watching a movie. I can't do screenshots. I can't pull certain things out and add them in. I just don't have the computer skills to do it. So I consider myself mainly an observer that goes out to try to prove things for myself. Number one reason why I started this was because I really thought Flat Earth was one big joke. But the more observations I started doing for myself, because I wasn't one to trust other people on YouTube at the time. Number one reason, too, my wife was telling me I'm being deceived by, you know, all these people on YouTube faking their videos and whatnot. So I had to go out and buy a camera for myself to prove to myself what I was seeing. And, you know, one of the things is visibility. You know, they're exchanging, science is exchanging visibility and calling it refraction, the bending of light, pulling things up from beyond the curvature and laying it flat out in front of you. My wife says I'm cheating because I'm using a zoom camera, and apparently she thinks my camera can see around corners. Nothing is being pulled up from beyond the curvature of Earth. It's all in the line of sight. My camera is not able to see around curves. Again, everything is in line of sight. Angular resolution, perspective. Perspective makes everything get smaller. And as it gets smaller, it drops. And you can do simple tests for yourself to see how these things will drop. Just by trying to line up, you know, things at eye level with, say, the same size object, further away. In order to line the two tops of, say, two aluminum cans, you would literally have to be looking down toward the second can. The first can, you can use your eye to get level with it. But then when you try to level it with the further can that has actually gotten smaller due to perspective, you would then be looking down. And that's why when I see these people doing these tube tests with water in them, they got one up close, one further away. Immediately I see that the one farther away is smaller. And when it's smaller, you actually are looking down to level those water lines out. So it is not a good way to try to find the horizon using that method. That method is totally messed up. And there was one guy that did a video, Mountains of Evidence. He kind of switched over, went back to being a globey, I think. I'm not quite sure on it, but we don't see him making many videos anymore. But if he watches this, I hope he watches it and understands what I'm saying. Because when he did his lineup, trying to line up some mountains, again, it makes you look downward. And again, you lose that level, straightforward look due to that perspective of objects farther and farther away. And this is why I wanted to add in and, again, make this into a long video. I know because my videos are long, I lose a lot of people's attention. And then on top of that, people don't want to spend a lot of time. They like the short version videos, you know, 5 minute, 10 minute videos that gives you all the proof in the world. Well, I can't do that. And I don't like cutting my videos. I don't like chopping them up. But I really respect people like Ben, and there's been a few other people that have used my footage. I do appreciate those that have the good editing skills to take my footage and edit it down to smaller videos where more people can watch them. I don't put copyrights against people that use my footage. I let them use it, and I'm proud to even say, use it. You don't even have to give me credit. Just go ahead and use my footage and let it go from there. Because again, more people get to see it, the better. All right, here comes the Bill Watts rack. Bill Watts rack is at 3.58 miles. And again, you can see water well beyond it, which you shouldn't be at my height that I'm at. And that's why I wanted to talk through this entire video. You also see these other boats coming in. You really do see them in the water. Yes, you're getting some obscurity due to the shadowing, the wake obscures things. Okay, this is the Hernando Beach rack that was, and I'm saying approximately 5.58 miles because I haven't actually confirmed it 100% that that's the distance. This is Billy Steele's rack at 7.73 miles. And this, again, is where my misidentifying these bird racks came. And also the day that I actually went out to each and every one of these racks in my boat. It got late in the day, and as I was coming in, catching these last racks, I was taking pictures from a farther distance away. I did not drive right up to them. It was getting late in the day, and we also wanted to get back before dark, but we also wanted to stop at the Hernando Beach Islands and try to do some video from there. I think we both ran out of batteries. Or no, we did do some observations, but that's in some other videos. But here again, you know, I'm tracking these boats that are well out there, that on a day where I don't have this visibility, some of these boats you wouldn't even have been able to see. These racks you would not have been able to see. But yet science wants to give us this lame excuse that this refraction of light is pulling things up and over the curvature of Earth and laying them flat out in front of us. Come on, people. Does that sound correct? I mean, it sounds really, really complicated because they use all these mathematical equations to come up with these reasons. But the better visibility I get, the farther I see. Some days I can see, you know, three of the racks. Some days I can see four of the racks. Some days I can see five of the racks. And then other days I can see all six racks that are within my line of sight from Bayport. Okay, so there's another thing that I will do in part of this footage because it gets dark. And right here is actually Cutter's Wall. Okay, this is a screenshot. I had my contrast set at 13 or plus 13, saturation minus 100, and brightness plus 10. All right, and then on this footage that I got coming up here, this little part here, I've got just the brightness brought up to 17. And as I go through the rest of the video, I will kind of bring the brightness up because in the original footage, it was getting darker. And the only way I can kind of show more of that horizon is by brightening up the screen. And again, with the screen brightened up, we can definitely see that horizon line does continue to go back, and you actually see other layers back there. Again, the way I see how perspective works, everything gets pulled down, including that horizon. Well, it appears to get pulled down, but appearing and actually does is two different things. But the visibility is the key. The greater the visibility, the farther we can see, obviously. And as you see me scouring this horizon line, I am trying to show all six of these racks that are within my line of sight at this particular area at Bayport. You know, I've been recently filming at another place called Pine Island, which we'll get into some of those later on. But, you know, these are, or this footage right here was the key for me to really understanding perspective in a lot better ways, realizing that, you know, no matter what, if I drew a line straight to each one of these racks to 6 foot, it's a constant looking down due to that perspective smaller size. You would always be angled downward. So again, the horizon is at level. Now Bayport here, I did a video where I had put a level on my camera and used the virtual horizon, and it did show it above the Bayport rack. I mean, literally above the Bayport rack. But again, if I drew a line to the 6 foot mark on the Bayport rack, it would be a downward line, not level. It would not be a level line. It would be a downward appearance. Same way here with the Bayport rack, I'd be looking down. So each one of these racks, if I drew a line to them, they would all be looking down because, again, there's water well beyond it. So eye level is up higher than what we see it at with our natural eye. Again, or with a camera on a bad day of visibility, that horizon line gets brought in much closer and everything, including the horizon, gets pulled down. All right. Again, thanks a lot for watching. I know it's a long video, and I hope I made myself pretty clear.